Los Angeles, we welcome Levi Johnston to Larry King Live, the ex-fiancé of Bristol Palin, the daughter of Governor Sarah Palin, and the father, he's the father, of course, of Bristol's son, Tripp. How are you handling all of this, this attention?
It's a little different with all the, you know, publicity and everything going on, all the media, and I mean, we got people camped outside the house and, you know, following my sister's school and that kind of thing. It's pretty crazy.
Are you surprised at it?
I never thought I'd be, you know, I was just a small kind of guy, Lubeck, small town, so, I mean, I never thought that ever happened to me, and when she finally told, you know, everybody that Bristol is pregnant and stuff, I didn't think it was going to get this rough.
But when the convention hit and all that, didn't you say to yourself, my gosh, I'm going to get caught in this. I'm going to be on stage. I didn't ask for this. I mean, I love this girl. I slept with her. But I didn't ask for this.
Right.
Didn't you think that?
A little bit, yeah.
When you were on stage, were you thinking at all about not marrying?
Not marrying Bristol?
Yeah.
No. I mean, at that time, I know, everything's going good. So that was always planned to get married.
What broke it up?
I think a lot had to do with, you know, just people, a lot of people bothering us, and I think it kind of just, you know, got to us, and we ended up just not seeing eye to eye with each other anymore, and things got tough. And
did you do the breaking up?
It was a mutual thing. I think we both decided to.
All right, you're now doing interviews like this. Why?
I don't know. I decided we were gonna do this one. I mean, I've seen a lot of your television shows, and it would be a great chance to come out and, you know, tell my side of the story, and I think a lot of people have the wrong impression.
Sort of clear the deck.
Yeah.
In a sense. All right, let's go back. Did the Palin family, did they seem close-knit? What was it like for you dating in the atmosphere of the governor's daughter?
They always treated me like a son. I mean, they're real nice to me. I thought of her as like my second mother, and, you know, Todd was always, you know, a great guy and helped me out with a lot of things, so, I mean, they welcomed me.
Did you like each other right away?
Doing
the Bristol?
Yeah, I don't know. We were young, and I think we met when we were really little, and I played hockey with his brother, and, you know, growing up, and went to school together, and I don't know, I always thought we'd probably get together at one point.
One thing led to another.
Yeah.
When it began to be sexual and romantic, did the Palins, that's a key question I guess everybody's asking, did the governor know?
You know, I'm not sure. That's the question I can't really answer, but, you know,
what do you think?
You know, she says she doesn't know, you know, but, I don't know, if I think she'd probably know, you know.
What about her husband? Do you think he knew?
I would think so.
Did sex occur in their house?
You know, Larry, that I'm a gentleman, you know, and I don't kiss and tell, so, you know, I don't think that really matters. I mean.
And how about the part, though? First you said you practice safe sex most of the time, right?
Right.
Most of the time.
Most of the time.
We noted one time that didn't happen. Were you surprised at the pregnancy?
A little bit, yeah. It came as a bit of a shock.
How did you tell Sarah?
We went over there, and we had one of Bristol's friends over there, and we all kind of sat down on the couch, and we ended up telling her that way.
What'd she say?
She was shocked. I mean, she probably didn't know really what to say. I mean, no mother wants to hear that her daughter's pregnant at the age of 18 years old.
We have an email question from Walt in Tarpon Springs, Florida. Bristol said in an interview that telling young people to be abstinent is not realistic at all. Yet Governor Palin's people say Bristol is working to teach the lesson of abstinence. What's your opinion on all of that?
You know, I'd probably have to agree with him. You know, I think all teens, or most of them, are sexually active. So, I mean,
do you think abstinence is unrealistic?
Yeah.
You know, is it that it doesn't work?
No.
By the way, how does Bristol's father react to the news? Fathers usually get angrier.
No, he didn't get angry. I mean, he was real cool with it. He was want to, I don't know, kind of sit us down and tell us what we had come to us. And I don't know, he was great about it all.
I interviewed Sarah Palin in November after the election. I asked her about Bristol's pregnancy and her response to it. Watch.
I looked at her and thought, Bristol, honey, you're going to have to grow up really fast. And she is a strong and kind-hearted young woman. She's going to make a great mom. She's very strong. She's going to be just fine. But Bristol has an opportunity at this point also to reach out to other young American women and let them know that these are absolutely less than ideal circumstances that she or any other unwed teenage mother are in. And it is not something to glamorize. It's not something to condone, if you will. Bristol has an opportunity to reach out to other young mothers and help them, and hopefully not see such a prevalence also of unwed teenage mothers.
Levi, was abortion ever considered?
No.
Giving up for adoption ever considered?
Oh, no.
When the two of you talked and the baby Tripp was born, was there ever a thought that you would not be the active father of that child?
No.
So what happened?
I don't know what happened to all that. I think somewhere along the lines that we just, you know, weren't hitting it off anymore. And
oh, but they won't let you see your kid?
I know I can go over there and see him, but it's now, you know, it's kind of a uncomfortable thing for me. Go over there, I want to be able to take him and do that kind of thing, go do the father thing with him, and I can't.
Why can't you?
You know, I'm not sure, you know, like.
Do you have a lawyer?
No.
Why not? I mean, your mother's coming on with it later. I'll ask her, but it came up now. Why wouldn't you hire a lawyer to fight for your rights as a father?
Well, you know, I think I don't want. We're not sitting here. We're not in a big fight with the Palins. I mean, I still like the family very much, you know, and I think we can work things out. I mean, I don't think either one of us want to go to the lawyers and try and fight for custody and stuff like this.
But then why can't you take your baby? It's your baby. Why can't you take your baby for a weekend?
I don't know.
But you're not interested in finding out legally why you can't?
I am. I think if it keeps going like this, I think we're going to have to.
Does Levi want Bristol back? Could they ever make a go of it? Now that their lives have been so exposed, we'll ask him next. Don't go away.